Hello? Anyone home? Could this be a finger in short time for Quagmire? Oh, what? What? Is that you, Siegmire? What?
Oh.
It is
Pardon
him.
Pardon me, I was absorbed in thought.
How?
I am Siegvert of Katarina.
Siegvert?
To be honest, I'm in a bit of a pickle.
And he has the same lines
have
as well.
Have you ever walked near a white birch only to be struck by a great arrow?
Yes.
Well, if I'm not mistaken, they come from this tower.
I don't think you're mistaken.
Whoever it is, I'm sure I can talk some sense into them.
Okay, then.
But I have to find a way up. And that's just the trouble. This lift only goes down, you see, and... Well, that doesn't get me anywhere.
But it did go up because he wanted to go back up. And what if you stand on the elevator and let me go up?
This lift only, with a little warming up, eventually... No.
What, you want to jump up there?
I've got to use my head and think.
Yeah, indeed. So I'm guessing if I activate it, it goes down. But there was an elevator on that other bit. So if I wait till it's all the way here, then I can use this one to get up. Oh yeah! That wasn't really hard, now was it? Now the question is, am I gonna get my ass kicked by that giant up here? Okay. Soul of a Nameless Soldier. I'm starting to move those up. No head ahead, only visions of finger. What's with that finger stuff? Everybody's talking about fingers. Oh, this guy is big. Hello, sir? Oh, I can actually talk to this guy. And they're even the same. So yeah, maybe I should talk about that a little bit. The guy downstairs in the onion armor is a familiar face from Dark Souls 1, in which you had to help him every time he came across an obstacle. Wow, we're high up. And these giants actually look a lot... This giant looks a lot like the giants from Sans Fortress, also from the first Dark Souls.
Who are you?
I'm a friend.
I help anytime.
A young white branch.
I help anytime.
Wait, is that it? What, seriously, was that it? I just make peace with the guy? What was that white branch? Oh yeah, I could take that as my starting item. So branch of a white birch received from a giant, apparently as a token of friendship. It becomes something that blends into the surroundings, consumed with use. Good friend, no hit. So, good friend, no hit. So, does that mean that we're cool now? He won't shoot me anymore? Because that would be awesome. That means I can use that other way to get to the tree fast as well. And I get those items. I can get those items. That's even more important. So, that's it then, I suppose. Let's get down and see if Siegmire has any... But his name was different now. It was Sieg... God damn it, I'm gonna suppose he took the other elevator again. Ah, night indeed. Okay, and if I go down now? He must be down here then. Hello? Hello? Be wary of monster. On the ceiling or? Try luring it out and then try lift. Siegmeier, I'm gonna keep calling him Siegmeier. Is that a smaller version? I need to get in here. Running. Okay. Ah, for fuck's sake. Damn it! I had him. But he's freaking fast. So he's a smaller version of that Vort guy. And I don't want my souls back. So now what's the fastest way of getting back? Over there. You can probably rush towards the tower. If I survive this fall, that is. Oh, yeah, okay. Okay. So let's kill this dude. And then I would want to... Holy shit! He's still following me. Leaving. Where is he? Wait, did he? Oh no. Did he jump off halfway somewhere? Maybe I can spot him. There he was. So that, those guys are leaving. So this is going up. I'm gonna visit Siegmeier in a minute. I do want to kill that monstrosity down here. And see what's behind him. Yes, I'm very adventurous. Thanks for asking me straight to my face. Luckily, my souls are right here. And now this guy... I forget that he sometimes... That's not how that works. Okay. Okay, I'm leaving. If I can leave. Whew. So I wonder if he tries to get down. That piqued my curiosity now, did it? Oh, this is so cheating. So he's still over there. Oh shit. Okay, this might be a problem. Does he see me? Because I'm scared shitless right now. Running! Let's play hide and seek with the giant frost monster. I'm still hiding. Look at him sitting there. I'm gonna kill you. Right about now. There he goes. Irritil Straight Sword. Interesting. This fancy thing. Straight sword bestowed upon the Outrider Knights of the Boreal Valley. So, confirming that he's of the same cast. This weapon is enshrouded in frost and causes frostbite. Every Outrider Knight one day devolves into a beast, constantly hounded by Pontiff Sullivan's black eyes. So that's the curse of those frost knights? Stance. While in stance, use normal attack to break a foe's guard from below, or strong attack to slash upwards with a forward lunge. Interesting, and it looks pretty cool. It doesn't immediately state that it does frost damage in the normal statistics, but I'll believe it if it says it does. Might even try it on. How big is this? Ooh. Pretty standard slashes. So it's the same as the sword I'm using now, which is awesome. But what was he guarding? Should I even open this? Hello? I'll just take a step here to see. Oh, there's a bonfire. A road of sacrifices. Okay, this is cool. I'm gonna rest at this bonfire and use it quickly. And then, yeah, I'm first gonna go to Firelink Shrine to use my souls. There we go, Firelink Shrine. And then we'll head back to try and find Siegmire again. There we are. It is fancy, this sword. Okay, she's sitting over here right now. Speak that. Very so level well, up. Then take notes. 3969 already needed. I might want to boost my dexterity first. Vitality boost equip load. Vigor. Might want to put a point into vigor as well to boost my survivability a bit. So let's do that first. And then we'll go straight back into dexterity again. So the main focus on offensive skills will be dexterity and intelligence, and strength is good where it is right now. So I'm gonna be on the lookout for a few of those weapons. I didn't really check out D&D. And the fire sword is now nothing anymore because of the fire damage. But it is cool that this Irritil sword has scaling, even though it has that frost damage on top. Do you have anything else to say? Okay. I have been talking a lot about getting some more spells. I'm gonna start with a miracle. I think I can use that. Yeah, there we go.
Ashen one.
So that will be a bit more interesting healing wise. And then add Andre. And let's reinforce. This one needs something. This needs Twinkling Titanite, like the old days. Twinkling Titanite, okay. And then the fire sword just needs Titanite shards. So that's cool. And the other one, the Uchigatana that I leveled up, also needs Titanite shards. So I'm gonna use my Titanite shards on the fire sword and upgrade that twice, because I really like that.
Pretty meeker, I don't.
So I'm only using this frost sword to see what it does, but I might as well buy a few more arrows from this guy. Just in case we need them. Give Loretta's bone. Oh yeah, right, we found her bone. So let's give him that.
Heavens, she was already dead.
Yeah, I'm sorry, guy.
Thank you. I'm not surprised, though. Almost a relief, really. You can keep the ring.
Okay, thank you.
As, well, a little trinket of thanks, I suppose.
Ooh, gift. What did we get?
You can keep the ring as...
Okay. The little trinket, does he mean the bone? Where were we? Arrows. Standard arrows. Yeah. Give me those.
Goodbye. Oh, this place is a bore. What good is thievery if you've nowhere to go?
Keep your hands to yourself, man. Don't know what the consequences will be if you do steal from somewhere, someone here. And the last thing I want to check, there should be, the pyromancer should be around here somewhere. Let's go find him too. Maybe he can give me another spell as well. Is this guy still here? Oh, he's gone as well. Weird, mysterious. So there's no one here. So maybe in one of those side hallways? I didn't check the right side yet. Oh, here he is.
Ah, there you are. I wish to express my gratitude for trusting a lowly pyromancer and allowing me to gaze upon this majestic flame.
That's a candle.
As promised, I will impart pyromancers to you.
Awesome! Can I level up my hand with you as well? Yes, reinforce pyromancy flame. The Titanite shards? Okay. Learn pyromancies. So fireball, I know fireball. Fire surge. and great combustion. Create powerful giant flame in hand. So that's interesting. Fireball is the one I'm using right now, isn't it? I think it is.
Do not be gone for long.
Yeah.
What is a teacher without a pupil?
Well, a teacher without a pupil, I guess. But first, I'm gonna spend some more souls. There we go. Seems. Oh, welcome. Thank you. Reinforce the pyromancy flame. Boosts it up to... Well, it's good for 11 damage more. And the scaling improves a bit too. So that's improved with Titanet Shards. And then learn... Would want to learn Great Combustion. Fire Surge might be a bit much. And what do you sell? Oh, my gear. Great.
Do not
okay, then.
Off. What is it?
The other thing I might want to start doing is buy maybe Soul Arrow, or is that 2,000 souls? Farron Dart, Fire Soul Dart. What's the difference with Soul Arrow? 7 and 3. It's mainly for luring, probably. I might want to buy a torch, actually. Though... We might find that somewhere. That's usually my predicament, that I might find something I want to buy. So let's buy that Fire Surge. Can't hurt that we have it. Nope, not Fireball, Fire Surge.
Do not pick up what?
Well, I haven't talked to you.
To learn pyromancies, you must vow to become my pupil. I know, but such is the way of the world. Respect your elders and so on. And pyromancy, of course, is no exception.
Okay.
Oh, you'll need a pyromancy tome to learn more advanced pyromancies.
Ah, interesting.
Though unorthodox, that would be the most expedient way to make progress. If this were the Great Swamp, and you had the luxury of time, we could have trained you the hard way.
Interesting.
To learn pyromancy,
okay.
Do not pick what
so
is
we
it?
Need a tome to have access to more advanced pyromancy, so that's interesting to know. So now, let's get back to Siegmeier and see if we can't help him, because he must have fell off the elevator somewhere. We haven't found any of those undead bone shards yet, so maybe later. So, Road of Sacrifices. And let's head back inside. Okay, that guy. I was a bit afraid if that guy would be back here, but he isn't. I look like a little fairy spraying that snow, that frost dust all over the place. So the elevator is gone, but I'm assuming I can get it down here with this lever. Or this lever, if you're from England. And there we go. Back in the undead settlement. Put it back down. There it is. And now we're gonna be a bit risky. We do need to jump off at a certain point. Oh, that's not it. I think that's gonna happen a few times. So bear with me. Oh look, my souls. I have 52 souls. So might have to jump off on the sides. Oh, I can't even jump off on the sides. So now he's humming. I didn't really see anything. Maybe on this side? Oh, yeah. Okay, that side. So get off, get on, and wait for the cue. Yeah, there we go. Okay. So now, where is our dear friend? Oh, here he is. He's sitting on the ledge again. Oh, that's a cool idea, actually. I talked to the giant.
Oh, don't disappear like that. You had me downright worried. But thanks to you, an epiphany has struck me square in the head. I've unraveled the riddle of this inscrutable lift.
I did too. And I feel so smart right now.
On some days, I begin to doubt myself. I went up the tower, so I thought. Then somehow
what
ended up
is
here.
That?
I'm not exactly sure what happened. Anyhow, do you see that? That humongous beast?
Yeah.
I'm no coward and I've a steady hand, but that thing makes my skin crawl.
You're not the only one.
Now, think twice before you go down that road.
Great.
I could try talking some sense into him. No, I think not. He's far too overheated.
We did that with the giant,
I've
but I...
got to use my head and think.
He doesn't look like a talkative person, that thing. It's like a walking dragon with an axe.
I could try...
Okay. So thank you. Sigurd was his name? Sigurd of Katarina? I probably could kick him off, but I have a little help. But I need to go down here anyway. Are those birds? Yeah. Maybe the giant will help? I don't know, I don't really have a choice at this point. Don't really have much to lose either, so no biggie on that front. I don't think my fireball will do a lot against that thing.
No! You should have waited!
Waited for what?
Well, it's too late now. I, Sigurd of the Knights of Katarina, fight!
Oh yeah, you're gonna help? Wow. Here we go, Frost Sword. Oh shit. Kill it! Yeah, there we go! Oh, sorry. Sorry, Siegmeier. Yeah, we killed it! Hell yeah! Thanks for the help, buddy.
It was quite a performance.
Thank you.
But you mustn't get in over your head. We Unkindled must put our duties first. But, for the moment, we've a toast to make.
Hell yeah. Siegbrow.
My sword and our victory together.
That was amazing.
Long
that was
may the sun shine.
Fucking awesome. Can I fist bump you back? Toast. Can I do toast? Let's switch point down for toast, and then do toast. He's not doing anything. That's too bad.
Well, I'm going to have myself a little nap.
And you've earned
it. The only thing to do, really, after a nice toast.
And there he goes. Okay. That was amazing. That was one of the coolest fights in Dark Souls history. The way that was set up, and that he comes to your rescue. He jumped down from there and walloped the thing. He didn't do that much damage, but what a cool thing to have happen. I didn't equip that miracle yet. So we're gonna have to do with this. We're gonna have to make do with this for now. Another tree, man. Anything over here? I'm totally lost at where we are right now. Oh wait, so that's... yeah, that's the entrance. So we're above those spot giants right now. Great. Anything here? Looks like it should. Okay. That's a bit of a useless... although you could probably use that to sneak around the beast. But otherwise, don't see much use for that. Large club. We got a fire gem from that monster, but we already have a fire weapon. So no need for another one just yet. We can go in there. Is there something over here? Doesn't seem like it. Oh. Is that thing gonna drop down? Because I know some of those dudes move. There are no enemies in this place, probably because of that dragon. So see, they are alive. Can't really hit them. Maybe with the stance. Okay. Oh, no, there we go. Holy shit, that scared the bejesus out of me. Oh, that was way too short. Whew! I knew it was probably going to happen, but that was fucking creepy. Anything else? I do like this frost sword. No happiness ahead, only visions of bad luck. Hi, fellow. Praise D, it'll happen to you. I don't want to change into a tree. There that goes. So, does that mean that I can change into a tree? Because I don't want to change into a tree. Holy shit, okay. Completely missed that. Okay, that's probably the stuff that changes people into trees. Oh wait, is there another guy? It's get back to the sword. I thought I saw someone. Human pine resin. We also found those red bug pellets. Medicinal pellets made from crushed insects, the red type temporarily boosts fire damage absorption. Prepared in the Cathedral of the Deep by evangelists who dole them out to followers to ease their suffering when they burn. And the human pine resin? Charcoal pine resin rotted with human body fluids temporarily applies dark to right hand weapon, normally used in the undead settlement for preservation and burials. It can mature into this state, becoming a valuable substance used in a certain ceremony, often seen for trade at exorbitant prices. We did get quite a bit of it. And then the Siegbrau special brew of Siegwart of Katarina, perfect for travel in its Jolly Barrel mug, restores HP and temporarily boosts frost resistance. Leave it to Siegwart to discover a drink that even an undead can enjoy. Perhaps his long years spent undead have left him wanting to drain a cup or two and revel as if he were still among the living. So that's interesting. Is that an indication that that is still the same man? What are these guys doing? Having a friendly chat? It's probably these guys that turned those people into Yeah, get over here. Yeah, knew I could risk that. And now the other one needs to die as well. Okay. And down he goes. Or she goes. It could be gender fluid, I didn't know. I really don't know. Okay. So let's check around here really quickly. And then, okay, this keeps going. There are so many routes I haven't taken yet. It's starting to spin my head around a little bit. But, is there anything of interest up here? Flynn's ring. I didn't even equip this thing. I'm gonna equip that in a second. Flynn's ring, lowering equipment load, increase attack. Ring of Flynn, the eulogized thief. Lowering equipment load increases attack power. Flynn fought with the wind on his side and was a hero among the weak and poor, yet even his admirers knew that it was little more than an idyllic fable. So that's interesting. How much of a change is that? I'm gonna grab that Bloodbite ring. So it raises it a little bit. It doesn't lower the maximum that I can do, so I am gonna equip that. Boosts to attack are always nice. It's up below. So you can get further down. I do have a lot of souls. But, oh! Yeah, okay, never mind. Well, that's a great way to end it, because I wanted to end that. So that was stupid. I hope I get back to that place without dying. But I'm gonna take a little break, so if you like the episode, don't forget to like it on YouTube, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And furthermore, thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye!